Welcome to the Blokes Podcast. I'm Adam.
And I'm Greg. And we sit down once a week to shoot the breeze. We chat about anything and everything. Sports, films, drinking, politics, music, etc.
So sit back, crack open a beer, and enjoy. Good morning, mate. How are you?
Morning. Yeah, I'm good. I'm very good. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad, thanks. This may well be the earliest we've ever recorded for the podcast, right?
I think you might be right. Yeah, it's bright and early. It feels good, especially with my lockdown jet lag, effectively, the way I've pushed my entire sleeping schedule back about 2 hours because I don't need to get up anymore for anything. Struggling, but I've got a cup of Joe here.
Nice.
He's helping me out. He's leading the way.
Getting you through. That's a nice cup you got there. It's one of those handleless mugs, right, that burns your hands. Completely unfit for purpose.
Oh, completely unfit for purpose. Looks cool, burns hands, scalds you. Yeah, exactly. Completely style over substance. That's how I live my life.
Yeah. Strong and wrong, baby. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
I've already had a coffee this morning, had a sort of espresso-based flat white sort of thing, you know, fancy machine and all that. And then, but I finished that and I was like, oh, I've got to have something to drink. So I dug out the AeroPress, right? This is a new contraption that I bought recently. Have you heard of this before, the AeroPress?
It's ringing a bell, but I couldn't describe what it is, so no, I don't really know what it is.
It's like this strange contraption that's like, it's made of plastic, and it's a bit of a combination between a French press, a mocha pot, and then I guess a bit of espresso. It's a weird thing. It's like, it's all plastic. It's got a little filter in the bottom, and you like put your coffee grounds in it, and then you fill it up with boiling water out of the kettle. Give it a stir, leave it for a bit, and then you sort of press the top part. There's another plastic bit that goes in the top and you force it down, and it uses sort of like the air that's stuck in the plastic bit as pressure to then extract the coffee, right?
Right.
So it makes a very strong coffee, but it's the amount of like a big cup of Joe, like American style amount. So it's like, it's really doing something this morning. It's like...
Things are in motion. Yeah. Things are moving. Yeah.
But it was,
I like it.
It's only £30, right? And, you know, coffee people like talk about it all the time, like online and stuff. And apparently it's what sort of, you know, quote unquote coffee professionals take when they go abroad and it's in their hotel room or something. It's like the best you can get sort of in a hotel room or that sort of thing.
Right. I see. Okay. Yeah, it sounds good. I mean, that sounds like right up my alley as well, to be honest. Like a decent amount of liquid comes out the end and it's strong.
Yeah, definitely.
So you're noticing a big difference between just your espresso that you had this morning and this in terms of strength?
Yes, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Right.
I don't know the science behind it, the chemistry, but it's definitely, it feels stronger to me. Like, and I've obviously had a few of them now, like since I bought it, and it's, yeah, every time I drink it, it's like, whew, it's like rocket fuel.
Yeah.
But tasty rocket fuel.
Perfect. Are you sort of wanting to like, maybe not have as many of them as you can? You don't want your body to get acclimatized to it.
You know, I've not even thought about that. That's probably a good idea. Yeah, I shouldn't sort of like up the bar, because then, yeah, like you say, you get used to it, don't you? And then you just need extra coffee.
Exactly, yeah. I've gone down that road too many times, so I feel like it's just be careful.
Yeah.
It's a slippery slope.
Oh, man. Well, I mean, the initial reason I bought it was because it was sort of for work. I was thinking, oh, you know, sort of like doing more sort of work like away from the house. I thought I'd get this thing and like make some good coffee at work. But then, then I've just been stuck in the house ever since I bought it. Obviously, like plunged into this third lockdown, so I'm just like trying to find an excuse to use it. Basically, so this is prime time for it.
Perfect, amazing. Maybe we could take a photo of it and pop it up so people can see what it is.
Yeah, big time. Yeah, apparently they even have competitions with this. There's like different techniques you can use to make the coffee from this thing. I can't think of any because it's super simple. It's like just two bits of plastic with a filter in it. But apparently there's loads of different things you can do, and they have competitions like all over the world and stuff. So
interesting.
Yeah. Getting deep.
Interesting. Okay, I like it. I like it. Now, I do actually have a coffee question for you. A cappuccino machine.
Yeah.
Is it extracting the coffee via pressure from steam, or is it just blasting steam through it and then that's condensing into water after it's gone through the coffee grounds? How does it work?
Oh, God.
is it forcing hot water through, or is it forcing steam through, which then condenses?
God, I should know this.
Sorry, I'm throwing you under the bus here.
I'm actually not quite sure. No, I think it's hot water. It's hot water. God, I shouldn't have spent all that money on that course. This would have been one of these questions. The certificate's useless. It's worth nothing.
Crying as you rip it up in front of me. I don't deserve this.
it's hot water. It's hot water. And then as it goes through, I'm not sure how it produces the pressure, though. I think the more expensive you go, there are like different methods of pressure.
Production,
yeah, exactly. Thanks.
Cool. Okay.
There's clearly not enough caffeine in this coffee. It's not getting me going enough. Oh dear, I need another one. But yes, sorry, I couldn't be more clear.
No, that's
I think it's water. Yeah, I know that it ramps up to about 9 or 10 bars of pressure. So I don't know what produces the pressure, but it's about 9 or 10 bars that's being pushed through the coffee at the end. So it's quite a lot. You know,
that is a lot.
I don't know how to compare it because I don't know what anything else is, but people say that's quite a lot, right?
So, well, I can tell you what you can compare it to. My car tyres.
Oh, right. Okay.
Because it's a French car. I have to convert at the PSI thing. I have to convert it to bar.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah.
Every single time. And then remember what bar is compared to PSI. Anyway, God, that's the most boring chat on the planet, isn't it?
But dad chat.
I think in a tyre, it's like a car tyre, which like it's explosively, like if you cut a car tyre when it's fully pumped, it will just blow, right?
Yeah.
So that's a lot of pressure. So I think that's like 20 something bar.
Oh, okay. Right.
So, but there's a lot of pressure in a car tyre. So
yeah,
I would say 10 is still a lot for a metal machine that could explode if it's too much.
Right, so in front of your face and hot liquid.
Hot liquid everywhere. I think 10's enough.
Yeah.
Too much for anything.
Yeah. Oh dear. Oh, so how's your week been, man?
It's been good.
Anything to report from Groundhog Day?
we no longer have a mouse problem.
Oh, great, great.
The mouse was dealt with. We flip-flopped between trying to scare it out of the room and just using a trap. We gave him a few chances. My missus tried to talk him down
from the ledge.
He just wasn't having any of it. Yeah, we literally stripped the entire room. Man, it's such a joke. In fact, I've still got remnants up. It turned into a clear out. We've got rid of loads of stuff I don't wear or anything now.
So that's positive
in general. But yeah, we cleared the entire room out. So it was just a bed frame and a carcass of a wardrobe, and we could not find where this freaking mouse was. So we think it was hiding underneath. There's like a cavity under the wardrobe where obviously it stands up from the floor.
Yeah.
And there's some space in there, I guess it was in. So we tilted it back. We tried scaring it out. It just wouldn't leave. So
So you could see it there underneath in that little area.
We saw it sort of scuttle under there, and we sort of pushed the wardrobe back, but we were getting close to it. We were shining lights on it. We couldn't. There was like a hat we think it was using as like a, that had fallen underneath it somehow, that we thought it was using as like a base of operations. It's forward sort of operating base. We saw it a couple of times moving when we shone a light on it, but it just wouldn't budge.
Right.
And then I had teaching actually. So basically we had like half an hour to try and get this mouse out. I was like, right, whilst I teach, let's just put the traps in. It probably won't bother with it because it hadn't up until this point. I went back after a few hours of teaching and the traps had done their business. So I did feel a bit bad, to be fair. It was a very cute looking animal. Mice are extremely cute looking, but
the big
also
ears.
Dangerous. They have disease and stuff. Big ears, nice little cute pointy face. So then we went on to like a full military like sweep of the entire house to see if there was like an infestation, right? Because it's very rare there's ever one mouse.
Right, okay.
But we looked everywhere there could possibly be anything underneath the kitchen and stuff. There was no sign of anything else. So what it seems like, because I looked it up, is one of our houses or one of our neighbours, maybe two houses down, has got a mouse problem.
Right.
And they're sort of sending like scouting parties out, just individuals that are like going into houses nearby. Because apparently mice come in from other houses. It's very rare that they come in from outdoors.
Ah, wow. I didn't know that.
Yeah, so, well, they're called house mice. And I think I looked this one up and it looked like exactly like a house mouse. It wasn't like a field mouse, which is tiny.
Right.
This is slightly bigger. Nowhere near a rat or anything, but it was bigger than like a field mouse. Anyway, yeah. So if you have any mice inquiries, just run them through to me and I can help you out.
I want to know what hat it was hiding under. Was it like a northern flat cap? Was it you can work out where he's come from by what hat he's got on.
It was I don't know what they're called, but they're like back in fashion now. They're like the Noel Gallagher style, like Britpop, yeah. Like those like hat, like I don't even know what they're called,
but
they've got a rim all the way around.
Like
what are they called?
A plant pot hat.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like yeah. Kangol.
That's it, exactly. Yeah. And I have no recollection of purchasing this hat, so...
Maybe the mouse brought it with him.
Yeah, maybe.
He's from Manchester. He's from Salford or something.
Oh, God damn. Yeah, that was... So that's the only exciting thing that's happened to me this entire week, mate. So, yeah.
Nice. It sounds like a sort of 90s, 90s family-friendly movie. Like the Borrowers style,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
Make a film out of it. Was John Goodman in it? He's in all of those films,
yeah.
Isn't he?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he is.
Flintstones and everything.
What about you, mate? What have you been up to?
Oh, now you've asked me. I should see this coming, shouldn't I, when I ask you? Why am I always so shocked when it comes back over the net? What have I been doing? Yeah, a bit of work, bit of teaching. You know, I've left the house like hardly at all. I don't think I've left the house. Like I've nipped to the shop, and I live sort of quite in the middle of the town. So the shop, like everything, is like within 20 seconds, basically. Like the gym when it's open, the train station, the shop, like the coffee shop. Everything is within 15 seconds. So. It's all super close. So, yeah, I feel like I've not even left the house, but it's been so cold. I actually didn't go outside when it snowed. I was like, unless there's enough snow for me to ski on, I don't want to know. I'm like, go hard or go home. I want skiing
all right,
quantities.
Grinch. Jeez. Scrooge over here. It's not even Christmas, but still.
I'm not going.
Oh, mate. Normally snow annoys me like anything because I have places to be, and driving in snow is just annoying. And dangerous, obviously.
Yeah.
And it just gets annoying after a while, doesn't it? But now I have no problem.
Because we've not got to go anywhere.
Like, yeah, cool. I'm not going to go anywhere. Looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
Made a little snowman.
Yeah, I saw your snowman. It looked good. I was surprised. Okay. I was surprised it didn't have a little corn cob pipe or something. Like, I hadn't thought
ahead. Yeah, but I should have definitely. I've got a perfect one as well. It's about 2 inches long. It's but great.
Nice. A little nose warmer.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh dear. I mean, it's to be fair, like this was probably quite a good snowfall because it snowed, everyone had their fun, it melted immediately.
Yeah.
That like very efficient snowfall. Well done, Britain. No hanging around. I mean, I don't know about out in the sticks. I'm sure there's still a bit in the countryside, but in the town, it literally was like a lovely amount. The kids went outside, threw a few snowballs, and then it just melted immediately.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah. I approve.
Yeah, I do as well. Well done.
Yeah. Well done, that snow.
So we've got a couple of segments today that I want to sort of delve into that we've discussed. But before the first one segment, I wanted to ask you a question. Now, I can't believe we haven't talked about it yet. And I just want to get your sort of thoughts on Trump.
Big T.
I feel like it's...
Donnie T.
Big T. You know him. The one and only. And I just I wanted to ask you... God, I don't know why I'm getting nervous now. I want to ask you, like, what... Let's sum his 4 years in office up. Give me a brief overview of how you've perceived it, because I feel like there's about 100 different ways to perceive Trump, and I think everyone's got their own way. And I'd just love to hear from you, because I feel like we might be slightly different, possibly, especially near the end. But anyway, give Are you happy with him?
Sure.
Did he screw it up? Did he do great?